Welcome to another edition of The Daily. I'm Samantha Eric here with Simon Borg. After an action-packed night in CONCACAF Champions League, Sporting KC tying with Real Estelí at home.
A surprise result, 1-1, and Real Estelí actually took the lead in this game. Real Estelí hasn't won a game in this competition since it's been playing in all formats, and they almost pulled it off here. Jacob Peterson with the late equalizer, and it came on bad defending. There was a corner kick that came in, and no one was marking Peterson. But again, the same scenario for Kansas City. They're at home. They're against a team that's packing it in, and they can't find a solution. It happened against Houston 2 years running. They have to come up with new solutions, with new ways of doing it, change the formation, do something. This is not going to cut it. This could repeat itself in the playoffs.
So what does Kansas City have to do to move on to the knockout rounds?
Well, they can hope that Real Estelí somehow beats Olimpia in the next group match. That's likely not going to happen. We said Real Estelí has never won in this competition. But then Kansas City will receive Olimpia at Sporting Park, and if they can pull off at least a draw, they're through. But bottom line is there's going to be all to play for in that match.
We'll have to wait and see what Peter Vermes does with his formation. They have a little time, but lots to focus on in MLS play, so we'll see what ends up happening there. Second game last night, San Jose Earthquakes at home beating Montreal Impact 3-0. Goonie magic once again. What happened in that game?
I thought the San Jose Earthquakes were out of this competition. They are somehow in a scenario now where they can move on, but they'll need some help. In this game, though, Montreal weren't 3-0 bad. They had plenty of chances, but Marco Di Vaio was not in the game. They had Andrew Wenger, Daniele Paponi missed easy chances. Montreal actually played decently, but then Chris Wondolowski gets a goal, Shea Salinas and Marvin Chavez. And the goal difference now in this one, 3-0, has now vaulted San Jose into the better position among the two MLS teams to somehow pull this out. But Heredia, the Guatemalan team, still at the top of this group, and the MLS teams are going to have to work together to knock them off. Heredia, with a tie in one of their last two games, they are through. San Jose, they have to hope for Heredia to lose. And then Montreal, they need a miracle. They need to win by six or more goals, so it's more complicated for them.
All right, well, we'll have to wait and see what happens next week. Stay tuned to MLSsoccer.com for complete coverage. CONCACAF Champions League at it again tonight. Yep. LA Galaxy hosting Isidro Metipan. They need this win, Simon. What are they going to do without Landon Donovan, without AJ De La Garza?
They still have talent, Samantha, to pull this off. They're at home. Look, Isidro Metipan from El Salvador, not to be taken lightly. They've been in this competition before. Tactically, they will create problems, not too dissimilar from what Real Estelí did to Sporting Kansas City. But LA desperately need this result because Bruce Arena wants to be able to manage his squad, especially with two games remaining in this group, both on the road and a lot of key playoff matches in that Western Conference coming up. So this is a must win.
All right, well, you can catch that game tonight at 10 p.m. Eastern on Fox Sports 2. Well, 24 under 24 continues, and Simon, we made it up to number 11. The next five have been released, starting with Fabian Castillo, Ori Rosell, Felipe Martins, Darren Maddox, and coming in at number 11, Jose Villarreal. So, Simon, how is this list shaping out for you? Big surprises?
Well, for me, huge surprise. If Villarreal and Maddox are 11 and 12 on this list, who is 1 through 10? I'm really curious the next 2 days now on this list who's coming out. Because for me, Maddox, he was number one last year, remember. Look, his confidence has been shot this year. Hasn't had consistent starting time. He's not been in the lineup regularly. After last year, that's a huge shocker. And look, there must be a reason Martin Rennie is keeping him out. And then as far as Villarreal, he had a great U20 World Cup, in my opinion, and qualifying with the U.S. national team. And then I think at the LA Galaxy, we're not seeing his full arsenal of talent. I don't think he's a forward. He's a number 10. They don't use number 10s at the LA Galaxy. So I still think, though, he is probably the number one talent in the league right now. So he would have been number one on my list. Very curious to see what this top 10 is going to look like.
Yeah, well, we want to know who would be your number one and in your top 10. So tweet us or leave some comments below. That's all we have for The Daily today. We'll be back tomorrow with more. We'll be right back.